The gendarme? Cruncher.
Pardon?
Tonight, ladies and gentlemen, a smooth song to entertain you and different the bird shall dance, mademoiselle.
Meet shoo-wadi wadi do wop, shoo-wadi wadi, pick me up and serenade, you look so fine. Do run, 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 do run, run. Someday soon I'm gonna make him mine. Do run, 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 do run, run. Yeah, gonna make him mine. Yeah, he looks so fine. And when he pulled me home, do run, 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 do run, run. Do run, 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 do run, run.
Each night I have a quarrel,
boom, boom.
It almost breaks my heart,
boom, boom.
That's why I'm so afraid,
boom, boom.
That we'll have to part,
boom, boom.
Each night I ask the stars up above,
boom, 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 boom.
Why must I be a teenager in love?
Some days I feel so happy,
boom, boom.
Next day I feel so sad,
boom, boom.
That's why I
I don't know.
to stop my allowance.
Oh, good. And I shan't get any more tuck if I have to appear in the magistrate's court again. That's my
dear.
Just calm down, you two. This is a brilliant idea. We won't get caught, I promise you.
Oh, we were in a little bit before. Last time we heard one of your ideas, the head promised to deport us.
You mean expel, Hubert?
No, I mean deport. Old headmaster's got some influential...
Rubbish.
Look, calm down. Can I get a word before you all start criticising? Why can't it? What I propose...
All right. No. Pass it.
In our pajamas?
No.
Over the wall?
With candles? Don't you think they'll mind?
Why should we think so? Song, was it, chap? Shall we sing Grandma Pond and Grandma?
being sweet.
As from midnight next Thursday, under a new pay award, barbers are to get fringe benefits.
Last night, a large hole was made in the walls surrounding the Sunnyview nudist camp, Biggleampton. The police are looking...
Said, standing up with his big cigar. So I started my piece that I'd learnt by heart and gave my all with vigor. A full 7 minutes it must have been, sounding forth as best I could. "Next, please," was a response from the front, and I thought at least he could have said it was good. "Waiting there," said the girl with the big blue eyes, as I entered back into the room. She looked all legs and boots and things, as I neatly tripped over the broom. Stupid me, my heart was pounding, you know the way it does. When you're expecting the important news to come, I took a treat, tried to relax, but my heart was like a drum. Half an hour passed as quick as a wink, when I was called again. "Fred Blunt," said the man Goldberg, "we like your face, your smile, your brain. This part is for you," Solomon Goldberg said. "How soon would you sign for us?" "Well, there's no point in delaying," I thought. "Right now, if you like, what a fuss." There were forms to be signed with prints big and small, all neatly stapled, hanging on the wall. Signed there, and there, and there again. Who were they kidding, me and my brain? I was now in the money with the leading part. Through Solomon Goldberg, such a tender heart. I thought as I made my way to the station, was this acting world right for me? Well, perhaps just for a short duration. Thank you.
Thank you. Listen to that. He got his head knocked, not his head, somewhere up here, his hat off. Then knocks him outside the George. They think I can make it out. They haven't got no evidence.
He's a problem.
Hey, Tosser took her off, that's what happened. I bet she's down the West End now. Park Lane or Berkeley Square. You were out, and you was her father as well. Got no one to cook you a bit of dinner now, huh? What are you going to do?
Well, I got our Lil. But she says we got to get married. Because she don't want to be the lodger no more. Thank you.
too soon.
Okay? It's when I'm speaking to him, you take his bundle of clothes, okay?
Yeah.
Right, you have to try and...
Hey! Get him off my clothes! Let go!
Why should we?
very trusting. Bit dim, if you ask me. Is your friend married?
Yes.
What does he tell his wife?
Nothing.
Nothing?
That's right. When he goes out, she goes to her bridge club, and she thinks he's going to his club.
Hmm. That's clever. Should we call you that?
Where are you going to this evening?
Oh, I don't know. I normally leave that to my friend. He usually knows good places to go.
What sort of places?
Well, you know, places where we can be on our own, not meet anyone we know. That's why we use his car. Where do you go to?
Oh, for a walk in the woods. Or a coffee bar. Depends on the weather.
Well, it can be nice and secluded in the woods. Nobody can see what you're getting up to.
Oh, don't do anything like that. I'm very particular.
Particular? What do you mean?
I don't allow any liberties. My friend calls me Modesty Maisie.
Modesty Maisie? Whatever for?
Well, you see, I better not my hat.
Doesn't sound much like fun. Wonder why you bother?
It makes a change when Gerald's out entertaining his clients.
That's how I feel about lodging. When he goes to his club, he thinks I'm going to my bridge club.
What? You?
Dominic! particular thing that is nothing whatsoever in any way, shape or form like any other.
Table.
no club, because in the napkin. You make up the day. Show it to the audience and tell the audience the number and the name of that card.
The Nine of Hearts.
Ah, madam, I see you're still with us.
Would you open the envelope?
And show the audience the card.
Oh, that's very good.
Nine of Hearts.
That's madam. Thank you very much. Go away.
Where's the magic?
My sister.
Every one around you, song.
fortnight ago and we haven't seen him. Perhaps he popped out to the shops.
Only you could go shopping for 2 weeks. It's a real mystery where he's gone.
A mystery?
A mystery?
A mystery?
If everyone else says it's a mystery, I'll have him sent to the tower. I'm trying to read the book, and it is a mystery.
There should be a law about it.
I thought you made the laws.
Not anymore, my son. It used to happen in the old days. Ah, the good old days. When we royals made the laws, it was so lovely. They were such nice laws, too. My great-great-great-great-great-great-great, my countrymen, how many greats, grandfather? King Arthur was the best.
You mean royal gravy, gravy!
subject again. You're across your car. Yes.
Sorry, Mum. Fascinated by those knights in their shining armor, defending the king. And the heir to the throne, of course.
All you could see were their slitty eyes.
That didn't go down too well last time either, Philip. I was afraid you were going to be sentenced to Chinese torture.
I see Andy, but where on earth have you been, Andy?
Well, have you ever tried looking for anyone in this place? It's impossible.
And now we've lost Mark. He went to the Royal Mews to get my horse.
Meow!
Come on, Diddle's not there.
Excuse me, Mark. Would you care to hold the lead? It wants to go out or something.
I told you before, Mark, it's not necessary to keep saying Mom all the time. A dozen times a day will do.
Guess what?
King Arthur, my great-great-great...
Don't let that cat in the corgis. Where are they, by the way?
Oh, Mater, please don't send Mark to look for them. I'll come back to the House of Cavalry or something.
I think our audience has had enough of this. Perhaps I should say a word to lift their spirits.
Well, after this concert, I think they'll need it.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are so pleased, Galway, so pleased that you should all come to see our
say when you're allowed to come forward, and you have something to a box of chocolate?
Yeah, I have a box of chocolates.
Right. Now, what else have you got?
You can do it again. I've got two glasses.
Right. But there won't be two each night.
Yeah.
Oh, Barry, come back. Right, here we are. Where on earth have you been?